What I'm doing here is on an aerobatics light, I'm sort of feeling for where any serious gusts are or anything like that, to make sure that we don't overstress the aircraft.
Yeah.
I'm also looking for the visibility to see whether I've got any nice pictures and references that I can look at in the distance, and it's really nice and clear to use things like Holbury Power Station or the river crossings.
Yeah.
It's always good to have something that's going to get your eyes away from the cockpit, out of the cockpit. And that's really the trick to doing good competition aerobatics, is by having good references. Not necessarily looking at the speeds and all that sort of stuff, but just knowing and anticipating when you need to start to roll out of a manoeuvre to absolutely be right on the point. And it's interesting because sometimes as you slow down, obviously the control inputs are very different from when you actually went into that manoeuvre.
Yeah.
So climbing turn, you hardly have to touch the stick to actually get it into the climb.
Yeah.
But to actually roll out of the climb at 45, 50 knots, you need a whole load of control.
Yeah.
So it's only by practicing those sorts of things you actually really get to feel it. Can't do that sort of thing in the simulator. So we're going to do a nice, we do our hassle checks on the way up, so we're going to be at 3,000 feet, just to the north of the airfield. Airframe is 146, which is that red line on the instrument and the ASI. Always good to look at where that point is, because you have to go around the clock twice on this aircraft.
Yeah.
You're always good to actually look at it on the dial, and then it's security, so good look, make sure that your sunglasses are on and there's no loose objects. We're not doing any inverted maneuvers or anything like that, so it's not something that we need to care about. And let's check the nasties on straps. You'll need to give your straps a tug.
Straps all good?
Yeah, straps nice and tight, good. Because sometimes, while you're on the aerotow, you're settled into a different seating position,
yeah.
And your straps might feel a little bit insecure, so you really want to feel part as one with the aircraft.
Yeah.
Our location will be just to the north of the airfield, and it's briefed with the duty instructor. And the final one is location, which is lookout. And I'll do two well-banked turns. One to the left and one to the right. For two reasons you do those clearing turns. One is to obviously make sure you haven't got anything in your airspace underneath, because you're obviously using a lot of height in the vertical plane. So you need to really give it a good look around. And the second one is to show everybody else that you're actually not burning and that you're going to do something a little bit serious.
Yeah. So that they know what you're doing as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, so they know what you're doing. There's nothing worse than doing a turn. Somebody on an evening party or something like and all that. That's Rob, he's good. But he must have found the thermal, and you're like, piss off.
Yeah, exactly.
Look at this, isn't that gorgeous?
They were really quite tall earlier.
Yeah.
They were like that one over there on the left.
Oh yeah, nice. Okay, so we're at 2,200 feet. So downline, onto a loop, straightforward loop, out into a quarter clover to the right, another quarter clover to the right, into a hump to bump, and then into a wing over.
Powered aircraft on the right.
About
our height.
Yeah,
really nice viz. I was saying to Greg earlier, considering how it started.
Can you help me with that?
Yep.
Okay.
Got that guide on the winch?
Yeah, so he is well below us. Okay, you alright, mate?
Yeah, I'm ready to go.
Holding it over the top. Yeah, that's fine. Landing it there, lob it on it. Okay, out. 110. Upper wing over to the right. Rolling. Perfect. And rolling out. That's 100 knots. So a climbing turn. So I do the right spine. What's the next speed decay? Picking up my reference point to be out at 180 degrees at 50 knots. Whew.
Woo!
Perfect.
It's good fun.
Excellent.
That was really nice. God, I tell you, I'm getting tired
for this shit sometimes.
I'm sure everyone on the ground saw that.
That was cool. Those quarter clovers are lovely, aren't they?
Yeah.
Right, we're just going to, we're at 1700 feet. I'm going to make sure we don't do anything to upset the circuit. We'll just go over to the north hand side, the west side of the airfield.
We've got the ground down below the ridge as our floor, haven't we?
Yeah, that's true. Do another loop. Top, holding it there in a nice circle. Well done, knot. And the final turn on fire. Let's see the other guy there. I'm just going to hold it there. Nice.
It's nice.
Cool. Right to 1200 feet. Do you want to carry on filming or do you want to do a little bit of flying?
I'll let you fly.
Okay, mate?
Yeah.
I'll show you an aerobatic turn because it's quite difficult.
Okay.
It's not a slam dunk. So we're going, I can see the aircraft in front of me, thermaling. I'm going to speed up to 60 knots. The two things to remember, Jake, are 60 and 60.
Okay.
I trim the aircraft out at 60 and now I'm going to go in hard to the right. 60 degrees, a bit slow there, come on, speed up a bit. No, that's rubbish. That's better. And then pick up your reference, and your dumbbell 360, which is Aubrey. And snap out of it. Ah! And we'll do one to the left, speed up a bit. We're 1,000 feet now, let's bury ourselves. Good, good. Well, I enjoyed that. Time to go home, I think. Undercarriage is closed open. So, undercarriage is down and locked.
great fun.